Oh, the lies we Amazing honor to be asked to do this, not only because Brian has a litany of great artists that he can ask to do, but also because we get to play with our heroes, Dead Milkmen. I'm just very, very thankful. If you guys are joining tomorrow, we're playing with the full band and Everybody Hits at 6th and Gerard. In the meantime, we're going to close with the song that we recorded.
Oh, come on, Lord. Thanks for here.
Brian, can you get Brian a second?
Brian!
I'm sorry to interrupt.
I thought you were back.
I just tried to flip this back on.
Ah, shit.
The whole thing came apart.
Sorry, I'll get it. That's my fault. Here.
There's a washer and a spring.
No, that's good. Here, I got it. This thing goes. guys loosened it, and I was like, oh shit, it wasn't doing it.
I was when I went, you broke it, you bought it. Is this your beer, Brian?
It is, yeah,
thanks. Are you going to say anything in front of us, Brian?
Stories that people on the web write into it about D'Angelo and I in Toronto getting really, really drunk and riding this ride called the Himalaya. And yeah, I was trying to talk to the other guys that were getting drunk and riding carnival rides with you. They wouldn't. Boo. But Dan, he signed right up for it. And then he was like, and took the number. And then as the ride went on and Dan got drunker and drunker because he snuck alcohol onto the ride, he was like, yeah, yeah, And then it starts to slow down and stop. He's like, all sad. I'm like, no, wait, Dan. It's going to go backwards now. He's like, yeah, and it did. And he's trusted me ever since. With everything.
Brian, are
you fellas ready?
Almost.
It's always the bass player that takes the most time. There it is. It's only four strings. My little brother calls it the sub-guitar.
From a Flight of Concord, it's the dad guitar, and that's the mom guitar. Like, Murray, go to the lawn! And then it's like, Murray, go away! Like, yeah, he plays the dad guitar, he plays the mom guitar.
I think my little brother is trying to make a dig at the bass by saying it was the sub-guitar. But it is sub-guitar.
Most people
think I don't know about his kinky sex life. If you have kids, now would probably be the time to enroll them in military school. Because I can't sense the one I do. And I just want to say, I'm going to bring everybody down immediately. Our friend George Manny was a really sweet guy. He passed away on Wednesday night. If tonight's show goes really well, it's dedicated to George Manny. If we suck, though, tonight's show is dedicated to Mike Huckabee. Because he is a dirty puppy fuck. He's a fuck's puppy. And now a song that I wrote between here and the stairway. If I wake up late at night, I know that everything will be alright. Crawling around on my roof is a woman who is also on my list. She was born in May, 19 years ago, in a little town outside Buffalo. I bet I'd fall into infinity, but the town folks did it, and they take her away. But now she's happy with the place to stay. And if I wake up late at night, I know that everything will be alright. Just come down on my roof. It's a woman who is also on my roof. storytellers on VH1? You want to tell us something?
I just hope I can remember the words for this song.
Yeah, I divide the world into two groups of people. This is all the people that know the lyrics to this song, and then Joe. That song is called All You Need Is Nothing, and I wrote every single note of it, except for most of it, which Steve wrote. Give it clean.
All you need is love, but that's one of the most expensive things I can think of. I heard somebody singing that all you need is love. Well, all you need is nothing. Called Big Words Make the Baby It was recorded right in that little, like, 3-inch square area on that rug. That's, yeah, we like to get a tight sound, so it's called Big Words. Big Words Make. That was a good, it would be a good title. Would be Big Words Make the Baby Jesus Cry. So we'll call it that. Once was a woman who had nothing to say, but she still felt the need to say it anyway. Never understood why people stayed away. She said the newspapers are filled with lies. Planted black gamers from Jewish spies. Atheists run the public schools, while communists dip into the public pool. No matter the facts, she sees the truth. Now she's got a philosophy. By a 5-year-old about a big puppy.
motto agreed. It was make the baby Jesus cry. Now we got a philosophy. Simple rule, a motto agreed. It was make the baby Jesus cry. I'm adjusting my app. Excuse me, Mumsy, I can't go yachting on the Riviera. I've got an app to adjust, and then I've got to finish building my diorama. Seriously, you play like a bunch of wind instruments all night long, you'll get like.
Here we go. One, two, three. Thought of my greatest color book, and you color really well. Don't call her outside the lines, or God will send you to hell. If God hates war, and God hates crime, but he really hates people who color outside the lines. If God, I'm not the next coloring book, but don't color outside the lines. If God doesn't strike you with lightning, he'll at least make you go blind. But people get sent to the attic, and people will roost in the cellar. But there's a special kind of hell for those who just won't learn the color. God is gracious, God is good. He has color in his book. God wears cotton, God wears rayon. And then they wrote in crayon. God is honest, they don't take Viola. Let's all thank them for Viola. Instead of business, coloring books.
What's wrong with you now, Prince Charming?
What a jellyfish! her back. You don't want to end up like this man over at Passages Malibu. That place saved my life. We're brought to you tonight by Passages Malibu. That place saved my life. And it also, it managed to get me out of jail.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You know what, Stuart? I like you. They're not like the other people here at the trailer park. Don't get me wrong, they're fine human beings. They're good Americans. But they're pretending to get back a cool course 16-ouncer, maybe watch some reruns of Fourth Division on Town 37. They're good people, Stuart. But they don't know what the queers are doing to the soil. You know that Johnny Worcester kid, kid lives in newspapers in the neighborhood? He's a good kid. Some of the neighbors say he smokes crack. I don't believe a word of it. I remember his 10th birthday, all he wanted was a burrow owl. He kept on his old man and said, Dad, give me a burrow owl. I'm the best guy in the last as I live. So the guy breaks down and buys him a burrow owl. 10:30, that's his night on my yard. There's a Worcester kid looking under the tree. So what are you looking for? So I look at my burrow owl. I said, you've been taking another goddamn mother stick. Everybody knows my mother. Sure, and a kid like that is going to know what the queers are doing to the soil. I first became aware of all this that summer about 10 years ago. My oldest boy, Bill Jr., died. And that choir vote comes to town every year. That year they can't do the ride called the Victor. You have to keep your hand and arms inside the Victor at all times. I love Bill Jr. He was a devil. He was hanging out saying, hey, look at me. Hey, look at me. Now he got decapitated. And they found his head over by the snow-cone section. Three days later, I'm on the mailbox. Turns out there's a letter inside. It's from Pueblo, Colorado. It's addressed to Bill Jr. And it's about, do you know what the queers are doing to the soil? Not doing it! If you take a little tour around any large U.S. city with a big underground homosexual population, Des Moines, Iowa is the perfect example. Take a little tour around Des Moines, Stuart, and ain't no goddamn good. Can't plan it. Church help can't build on it. Government says it's through poor farming techniques. But I know it's the queers. They're running the aliens. They're building landing strips and gay marshes. I swear to God. You know what, Stuart? I like you. You're not like the other people. Here in the trailer park. Thank you. That's been InfoWars with Alex Jones. Yes, oh, baby. My favorite kid. Say so, baby. Oh, what the dick is. Oh, I lose control. When you serve for leg assault. Say you're cooking, baby. I got an appetite. I say you're cooking, baby. Smell out of sight. Oh, I lose control. When you serve. Maybe I love the way you look. Maybe I love the stuff you cook. Ow! The way you look. Ow! That stuff you cook. Bless all, baby. Not feeling fine. Bless all, baby. We're gonna die. Oh, I lose control. Wait, sir. But let us all. A little bit of soul and I'm feeling bad. A little bit of soul and I'm losing my mind. Ah, feeling bad. Ah, losing my mind. Play soul, baby. And my favorite dish. Play soul, baby. Oh, what is this? Yes. Oh, I lose control. Wait, sir, but then a soul. This is a song about bronzing dead bodies, which someone actually had a patent to do. I made the mistake of telling him about it.
1, 2, 3.
Don't be hating on the electroplating dead body too. If your beloved passes away too soon, it can help you with the gloom. The end of time, they'll come copper or bronze. They'll last to the end of time, and you can keep them close. time to please. Commemorate your final dying day in fight decay. Well, that's the end of time. A level copper or bronze. Well, that's the end of time. We can keep that rules. We used to find socks in our silver nitrate baths. We use only grade 8 copper and our bronze when our fees surpass. Our wars we will save, our wounds will close. And if you really, really like, you can customize the pose. Commemorate your final dying day. Now I lay away. Don't worry, girl. The endless summer dance on our special plan. Only $19.75 a dollars per ounce. And if you act now and expire within the next 3 years, you'll receive a 20% rebate. The Dead Body Tomb Company is not responsible for unexpected future resurrection. Body weight obtained before disembowelment. It's a beach party in Vietnam. Something with the Vietcom. Cooking hot dogs with napalm. A beach party in Vietnam. Frank the internet was laying on sand, but Frank got a letter from his uncle saying to get Snoop Dogg and all your friends. You're all invited to a beach party in Vietnam. Something with the Vietcom. Cooking hot dogs with napalm. A beach party in Vietnam. Frankie!
Frankie,
yes? Where are you?
I'm hiding under the rug!
Why?
I'm so high right now, nothing can hurt me!
Ah! He's fought in Vietnam, something with the Vietcong, put hot dogs with J-Pom, he's fought in Vietnam!
My phone!
Betsy wants Frank and Green. Frankie wants to get things are laying on the west coast. We're gonna have a wiener roast. The beach hot in Vietnam. Surfing with the Vietcom. Cooking hot dogs with K-pop. A beach hot in Vietnam.
I remember I'd just gotten back from being on tour for 18 months with Aerosmith. Yeah, they were as surprised as you are. Eventually, I was discovered on the bus, and Dan had to pick me up. And as Dan was paying the fine, he was whistling this lovely little song, and I said, Dan, that is a pretty little song. What do you call that song?
Meaningless, upbeat, happy song.
2, 3, 4. Did you suffer from depression? Well, you don't. Maybe you should. Because the world's a terrible place. And the only people who can't see that are idiots to the blind. And believe me, brothers and sisters, blind people can smell how bad it is out there. Hey, I've got some words of wisdom. He's got some words of wisdom!
Don't trust the happy are insane. If you see someone smiling, run, get away. Don't trust the happy are insane. And if they try to hug you, break out the pepper spray, cause you can't trust the happy.
If you didn't check the box next to I'm on the chat, there's something seriously wrong with you. The world's a terrible place. It's filled to the rafters with cretins and morons. Have you ever seen one of those child beauty pageants? Sure, it's an easy target. That doesn't mean it should be a target. Have any people ever read Harlan Ellison's Our Little...
Don't trust the happy are insane. And you see someone smiling, run, get away. Don't trust the happy are insane. The happy are insane. If they tell you Jesus loves you, run away.
no fuck. Just charm not surrounding, nailed to a cross. Don't pick that old shit, get no relief. People shaking their heads in disbelief. Just me on a hilltop with a thick piece of girl. And I know somebody wants you that'll make your hair suck. Don't pick that old shit, get no relief. People shaking their heads in disbelief. Charles Dustin Riley, he's our man, he can't feel the sick. When in fact they hit ya, can't walk on the water, can't make fun of. Just another big actor on the same stage. So don't piss, I don't shit, get too many. People shaking their heads in this fun. Just be on the top with the finger. And if that's somebody right, holds you down, make it happen. Don't piss, I don't shit, get too many. People shaking their heads in this fun. Music and egos, you go like bring up our friends' hot breakfast right now. Matt and Jill. We're Jill and Matt. They don't care what you call them, hot breakfast. This is their new album. It's called The Big Reveal, and it's very angry. It's a really angry.
What?
You know, I like it a lot because I like angry music. But I mean, you know, a lot of these songs are really, really, really angry, and that's what I like about it. It's a song called New York Drama. Very angry. Oh, Nobody Matters But You. Get this record. Nobody Matters But You is a very, very angry song. I like that a lot. So go out and get this. And we're going to do a song now, I believe, which is, I think it's called Back in the Saddle Again by... I'm back on the tour bus again in my mind. Oh, God. Oh, God. Steven Tyler is trying to show me his mole. Oh, God. Must go to my happy place. Oh, my happy place is doing the Prisoner Cinema. So let's do that. Nobody writes songs about the poor anymore, which is really a shame. We could use a couple more, cause we're tired of hearing about limos and jets, $200 ties, $1 million pets. So let's raise a glass to the salt of the earth, not that ass in first class, enjoying the perk. Some praise for the maids who cleaned up the rooms after they were trashed by the late King Moon, or the guy who fixed the TV. Elvis Scott, the daddy who watches kids while McCartney scores pot. The stage hand without the guitar that Hendrix set on fire in the swamps of Jersey. Someone changed Springsteen's time. Let this be the start of our revolution. Let this be the day that we take it all back. Let the writing on the wall be our manifesto. Let this be the day we go on the attack. They call it the Prisoner Cinema. These films that you see in your mind, when after 10 hours in the cubicle, it's just part of the daily grind. They lower your wages and increase your hours till you're nearly working for free. They cut your vacation and then your lunch hour and tell you you should feel lucky. Let this be the start of our revolution. Let this be the day that we take it all back. Let the writing on the wall be our manifesto. Let this be the day we go on the attack. They will never see it coming. No, they'll never.
We left them speechless. Matt and Joe from Hobbitas!
Thank you.
If you can, please pick up one of these on your way out. But also, if you pick up one of these, pay for it, because I am in a lot of trouble at Walmart. Joe has to retune for this next song. You guys can start without Joe. I do that all the time. Start the car without Joe. Horrible sweaty man. The rules are for the players, but we make the game. We say it's getting better, but it's all just the same. You're not fighting for your country, you're fighting for us. And as we party on the bodies, you dance with the stars. The way to kill a weed is pull it out by the root. So put a bullet in the head of every fucking suit. That little song I sing on my way to work every day. It's by Caustic. As you can tell, I came, you can't tell. If you look at the top of me, I put a t-shirt. I came right from work here. And I actually just do a t-shirt and thing. So I'm in my business attire. I'm in the reverse of how I normally am. Normally, I'm all business up top and all party below the waist. But today, I'm all party up top and all business below the waist. And I work in, does anybody here work in like a big high rise? They have an office job? Only me, probably. That's really weird that I would be the guy with the office job. Yeah, the office job. I've noticed this in the last week or so. They started having these preparedness classes for offices. And yeah, it's like they, okay, we'll show you what to do if there's a fire and an earthquake, and which is good, I'm fine with that, because that could happen. And then they're like, and also what to do if someone comes in and starts shooting up the place. And I'm like, statistically, it's less likely to have a shooting in here than there is getting struck by lightning. And that kind of dawned on me. For the last couple decades, old white guys have been shooting up offices everywhere, literally, going postal, you know, walking into the occasional Planned Parenthood and unloading with Uzis. And then, in the last couple weeks, two brown people shoot up an office, and all of a sudden, I have to learn how to become inner office ninja. Like, all right, we're going to teach you how to hurl this coffee pot. No, I'm absolutely, and it really, really, I mean, I think it puts a mindset into people, which is, we were okay before when white guys were shooting up the office. But now, oh boy! And I think it's also leading to a certain amount of assholery. People say, by assholery, man, I mean when people say, this is not politically correct, but and you know the worst line ever is coming. You know what I mean? Like, this is not politically correct, but anybody two shades darker than me, we need to enslave. And, you know, you're like, that's fucked up, dude. And I noticed that in the last couple weeks, people have gotten really bold about saying stupid shit out loud. Like, they used to use a dog whistle, and they would say, I'm for states' rights, and we know what that meant, right, you know, yeah, or that, you know, I'm for traditional marriage, like your dad and a hamster, or what, and, normally I wouldn't give a shit about this. If people talk shit, that's fine. I have friends who are Hindus, I have friends who are Muslims, I have people like myself who are atheists. Do not say this shit in front of my friends, okay, because I think it's a lot of paperwork for me to go up to HR if somebody says it's in the office and spend a day up there filling out. It's a lot less time for me to just put your fucking teeth on the floor. All right? And I mean, I know violence isn't the answer, but maybe it is. Like, did they, in the preparedness class, did they teach you what to do if you talk like an asshole and some guy who's 2 feet shorter than you just puts your lights out? And the reason I'm really upset about this is, first of all, it's un-American to act that way. This is America. As long as you can see over the bar and order a beer and keep your lawn mowed, we don't give a shit what you believe in. Dear God, we've got Scientologists making movies. But the thing is, it means more to me as a Philadelphia, because Philadelphia is where we came up with the idea for America, all right? Everybody else, they ripped that idea off from us. Zoos, that was us. The computer invented here, okay? The Stickmen, great band, came from Philadelphia. What Joe didn't believe you about ENIAC? Yeah, don't talk to Joe.
Don't talk to me.
Yeah, really.
Don't even look at me.
Yeah, I forgot he was over there, to tell you the truth.
I'm just not here.
I got all excited, went on a roll, and now I just negated everything I said. I don't. No, I'm serious. Please, if you hear people just being idiots, please ask them not to be idiots. We can shut down idiocy. You're free to have a stupid opinion. You're free to express that opinion in a non-offensive way. I don't know if you can, but just do not make any of my friends cry, because I will make you cry in front of your significant other, and you will look like the whiny little bitch that you are. Now, I know that's not very PC. That's like the only time you can say that and be cool. I know this is not very PC, but I'm going to make Mike Huckabee look like a whiny little bitch. Shit, now I went all over with it. Sorry about that.
How did you get here from work?
Subway, actually, because I'm broke. But if I were to drive, I would have a car.
What kind of car?
I would have a bitchin' Camaro. Bitchin' Camaro, bitchin' Camaro, I ran over my neighbor. Bitchin' Camaro, bitchin' Camaro, now in all the papers. My folks bought me a bitchin' Camaro with no insurance in that. If I had to burn you down, please don't leave a scratch. I ran over some old lady one night at the county fair, and I didn't get arrested because my dad's a bear. Bitchin' Camaro, bitchin' Camaro, donuts on your lawn. Bitchin' Camaro, bitchin' Camaro, tell your landlord and dawn. When I drive past kids, they all spit at me. Cause I got a bitchin' bus, and they have to ride a bus. So you better get out of the way when I come through your yard. Cause I got a bitchin' bus, and an extra credit card. Bitchin' Camaro, bitchin' Camaro, hey man, where you headed? Bitchin' Camaro, bitchin' Camaro, I jump on a leg!
Someone stole my beer!
It was that kid.
I know, I was about to sing an Irish song, and I can't do the... Oh, thank you. The Irish song, my people are from the Orkney Islands in, which is north of Scotland, and I do the lovely, my mother sent, was telling a story, my mother sent me a lovely Scottish Christmas card, and I just, if you just, I'm not really, you know, I'm an atheist, but I really, this touched me, and I just, you know, I'm getting off track here, but I'm gonna cry when I think about it. It was absolutely beautiful. It said, "You're born in pain, you live in fear, you die alone, Merry fucking Christmas," and I think, as a Scotsman, that meant a lot to me. This song is about part of Ireland where people of different religions have gotten together and been killing each other for a long time. In a mean abode on the side of the road, there lived a man named William Bloat. And he had a wife, she was the bane of his life, but she always got his goat. Till one day it thought, when he slapped her off, he slit her wrinkled throat. Now he was glad he had done what he had, as he lay there still and still. Till sudden all of the angry law filled up with a fearful chill. So to finish the fun, so well begun, he decided himself to kill. So he took a sheet from his wife's cold feet, and he twisted it to a rope. Then he hanged himself from the pantry shelf. It wasn't easy, and let's hope. With his dying breath, while face to death, he solemnly cursed the Pope. Now the strangest turn of this whole concern, well, it's only just beginning. So he went to hell, his life got well, yet he's still alive and sinning. For the razor blade was German made, but the rope was fell fast linen. We'll be right back.
the scent, these tough guys are dear. We are here to fight, and one pulls a knife. It's me in the back, but I'm alright. I'm alright, I'm
being on tour with Aerosmith. I'm back roadieing again.
Good
vocal exercise. Good vocal warm up for this song.
Jellyfish.
God, if you say that one more time, somebody will be reading about you in the paper.
Jellyfish.
I know he's going to say that. I'm now going to have nightmares. Wendell brought it to life in his guest room bedroom. It was a special project for his 4-H club. Broke loose out in the middle of the night, and now it's eating flower children. Left and right,
all the punks are gonna scream and sing. Cause it's a thing that only eats a day.
First, it cruised on out. It ain't the butthole, sir, cause you were too tough to chew. So it slid in its way out to home earth by. It ain't a couple of hippies, what it takes you just by.
Now it's got a sweet tooth all on hand. So Bob and Greg and Grant, you should be waiting.
Kids, ask your grandparents about who's your new.
Wasn't born in 1966. It's just turned on music and begins to sway. Dreaming as in dreams of a hippie souffle. Hey, hey, hey!
What do they taste like? Some kind of treat? How many hippies did this monster eat? It ate pills and masks before they could shout, and then it shoot on David Crump and loaded.
Spin out! All the pops are gonna scream your name. Cause it's the thing that only needs your name.
There it goes, and it's gonna bring back the drug addicts and the hookers and everything else that used to make this neighborhood great! No more artisan popsicle! No more craft beer!
Sun is morning, rain is the dawning. It's just a restless feeling by your side. Earth is dawning, sun is morning. It's just the wasted year, so behind. Watch out, the world's behind you.
something. Watch out! Thanks very much to Brian and Weathervane for having us here. Thanks very much for Hot Breakfast for being the two most talented people here with us. And thank you very much to Two Knights of the Northern Arms. Next time, bring the rest of your posse. Come on. Thank you all very much. The night's still young. Start a fire.
Thank you, guys. Let's give another round of applause for the Dead Milkmen. I want to thank everybody here for helping us make 2015 so good, and then so many people here are helping us make 2016 good. So just by being here, so thank you guys all so much. I think there's still
Brian.
I can get that started. Actually, do the Dead Milkmen actually know a lot of songs? Enough to play more of them? Yeah, do another one. I think.
This is my friend Amanda's favorite Dead Milkmen song, and she asked me to do it one night and with her, and I had explained to her, she was playing a show, and I explained to her that I don't do anything on this song, and yet. If you watch me, I might be the best part. Broke it, you bought it, you hippie.
Wrong switch.
Told you I was the best part.
What?
He has to know. He
just has to know. 3/4 of the way into it, he figured it out.
Hey kitten, what you doing? Wanna play the guitar? Say, what's that sound coming out of the hole in the wood? You say, what's that sound coming out of the hole in the wood? You say, what's that sound coming out of the hole in the wood? The guitar. Hey, baby, what you doing? Playing with your rattle and your plastic car. You say, what's the sound coming out of the hole in the wood? You say, what's the sound coming out of the hole in the wood? guitar. I hope you're not going very far. What's that sound coming out of the hole in the wood? Hey, what's that sound coming out of the hole in the wood? Hey, what's that sound coming out of the hole in the wood? Why is the guitar? It's the guitar! 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 It's the guitar!
That was excellent, Joe. But I played more instruments than you did tonight, so I win. Thank you all. We have fun. Thank you. And we'll see you again as soon as we find out what the statute of limitations on vehicular homicide is.
Everybody has permission to stuff beers in their pockets on the way out, too. And look in the fridge before you go.
I hid my beer somewhere else.
Because there's some of them in there, I think, too. And if there's any sushi left, thanks to the Boyds.
I hid that, too, somewhere else.
Thank you, guys.
No, 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 no,
Universe. Yeah. Like, Mayor McCheese is ridiculous because he has, like, big metal